bridges. I've never seen so many lovely pictures all in one place. We had a great vacation Bible school this last week. We had a lot of members here that were involved in one way or the other, and we appreciate every one of you and the work that you did. And even if you were just here to participate in the adult Bible class, it was good to see you. And we pray that the impact that it had on all the students, both young and old, will be felt for years to come. I've mentioned this to you before, that a friend of ours who preaches for the Lord's Church in St. George, South Carolina, was first introduced to the Lord's Church through a vacation Bible school. His aunt invited him to VBS one year. Now, he didn't become a Christian until years later when he was in college, but he was first introduced to the church through VBS. So we never know what kind of impact such an event will have. Because last Sunday was Vacation Bible School, we put off our sermons from our favorite songs until today. And so today I want us to consider the thoughts from the song, Just As I Am. It was written by a woman named Charlotte Elliot in 1835. And when we sing this song, you will notice, if you think about the words, you will notice that she begins the song with a feeling of unworthiness, a feeling of worthlessness relative to the greatness of God and really relative to the possibility of salvation. Sometimes you and I feel that same way. Now there are those on the other end of the spectrum, and I've met them, you may have met them some before too. I think they're in the minority. And yet there are some people who act like God is blessed to have them in His service. But that's not the way most of us feel, and that's not the way this songwriter feels. But rather, most of us feel when we think about ourselves honestly and soberly, we think, what can I contribute to God? It is so meager and so little. And that's why she comes to the song with. When we think about worthiness, sometimes we think about it in terms of cost. Well, that's not worth it. I don't even know how much a Lamborghini costs. Well, I can't even use it. It's so far out of my league, I can't even tell you how much it costs. But the worth is more than I'm willing to pay. I might want to take a cruise, and I might have the $3,000 or $5,000 or whatever it takes to take a cruise, but it might wipe out all of my money. So I don't think it's worth it. See, it's the idea of worth. We deal with things that we believe are worth what we pay for them. To use cars as an example, if I want to buy a $40,000 car, for example, then I think it's worth it. I might not want to pay that much, even if I could, because I think, well, it's not worth it. I'd rather put the money into a house or whatever. And so we deal with questions of worth all the time, even something that's very small. We might go to the store and say, a bottle of log cabin syrup is $2.80, and it's worth it because I like the flavor of it. I'm gonna pay $2.80 for it. Spiritually speaking, we look at ourselves and we think, I'm not worth it. What can I contribute to God? What can I do to help God's overall plan? I'm just not worth anything to Him. Of course, we know that's not true when we think through it. But oftentimes we feel it in here. I'm not worth a lot to Him. But Jesus comes and dies on the cross for us and says, you are worth it. God says, you are worth my Son. And that's the message of this song. Just as I am, I'm going to come to Christ. Just as I am. And the song says, Christ is going to make me better. You may have talked to people sometimes and they say, well, when I get my life straightened out, then I'll become a Christian. If you can get your life straightened out without Christ, you don't need to become a Christian. If you don't need Christ to help you straighten your life out, then why become a Christian? Christ is there to help us straighten our lives out. Not there waiting for it to come to him because we're already healed. In fact, we can't be healed without him, can we? Same thing is true of service in the church. We say, well, I won't become a Bible class teacher until such and such. Well, if you want to learn the Bible, then become a Bible class teacher. Because that's when you learn more, is when you have to start preparing to teach somebody else. The song, Just As I Am. I'll come to Christ just as I am, and let him make me what he wants me to be. Let's sing this song together, Brother Russ Lee.
This man was in when we were introduced to him in verse 1.
And he did not even know that seeing would be possible for him. Chapter 9, verse 1. As Jesus passed by, he saw a man blind from birth. So the man is just sitting there, and in verse 8, it says that he was a beggar. So he was sitting there begging, wanting anything that anybody could give to him. And Jesus comes by and he sees him. This first verse of this song, the author, Miss Elliot, says there is one plea that she has. She says the one plea is that I come to Jesus, O Lamb of God, I come. Your blood was shed for me, and you bid me come to thee. Now, other than the resurrections that Jesus performed during his lifetime, I don't know of another miracle that Jesus performed on a person who never asked for it. The blind man does not ask to be healed. The reason why Jesus heals him is because the apostles asked, who is it that sinned that this man would be born blind? Was it him or was it his parents? You see, they had the mentality, and it was a very old view about God, that if you're suffering in this life, it's because God is punishing you. Now that's false. That is a false view of life. But Jesus tells them in verses 3 and 4 that this man was not born blind because he sinned or because his parents sinned, but God allowed him to be born blind so that he would be there when Jesus walked the earth, so that Jesus could heal him of his blindness and show that he was the Son of God. That's the reason why this particular individual was born blind. And in verse 6, we have the record of Jesus healing the man. Very odd way to heal, even for Jesus. When he had said this, he spat on the ground and made clay of the spit and applied the clay to his eyes, and said to him, go wash in the pool of Siloam, which is translated sin. And so he went away and washed and came back seeing. The man could contribute nothing to Jesus. He could not be a preacher, probably even as far as he believed. Now, we've got a friend, Rachel and I do, who's a blind preacher in Indiana. He even came over and did mission work. Now, don't tell me a blind preacher can't do mission work. He preached. He brought a Braille Bible with him, and he preached from Braille. And one of our mission team members translated his English preaching from the Braille into Romanian. And that was kind of neat. But this man probably didn't even think he could do that. I can't do anything because I'm blind. Was not looking for help. Spiritually speaking, there are a lot of people who just are not looking for help. But Jesus would love to be able to heal them. Jesus bids them come to him so that he can heal them. But they don't believe they can be healed. They don't believe that there is forgiveness for whatever it is that they've done. And there are a lot of people that feel that way. And yet, Jesus says, you come as you are, and I will make you better. You see, none of us deserve to be saved. None of us. The wages of sin is death. Romans 6 and verse 23. So we don't deserve to be saved, but Jesus says, I want you to be saved because I love you, not because of who you are, but because of who I am. Jesus did not heal the man from his blindness because of who the man was. Jesus healed the man from his blindness because of who Jesus is. Because he's love. And the Apostle Paul writes in Galatians 6 and verse 14, when Paul came to realize that he was saved by the grace of God, not because he was a well-educated Jewish teacher of the law, that's not the reason why he was saved. He was saved because of the grace of Christ. And Paul writes in Galatians 6 and verse 14, God forbid that I should glory except in the cross of Jesus Christ, by whom the world is crucified unto me and I unto the world. And the second verse of the song, just as I am, Miss Elliot writes, I am not waiting to rid my soul of this one dark blot, coming to thee whose blood can cleanse each